Hello again and welcome back to our course on Project 2016. In this section we're going to look at dependencies, and as we're doing that we're going to add quite a bit more detail to the plan for the wedding. A dependency reflects the fact that some things happening depend on other things happening. The way in which they depend can be quite complex, but in a very simplest type of dependency we would say that one task cannot start until another task finishes. But we can have much more complex dependencies than that, and in particular one task may depend on many other tasks. Now let's take a pretty straightforward dependency to begin with. Let's look at tasks 6 and 7, select wedding dress and order dress. Now clearly you're not going to order the dress until you've selected it, but as soon as you've selected it you may want to order it. If I want to record in my schedule that one task is dependent on another, the very simplest way of doing it, let me select the first task, which is 6, select wedding dress, hold the control key down, press 7, order dress, and then on the task tab in the schedule group there is a button, a chain link button, that says link the selected tasks. You can link tasks so one can't start until the other has finished. And this establishes the very simplest kind of dependency. If you look at the Gantt chart on the right, you can see an arrow indicating the dependency whereby task 6 must finish. You can see the arrow there starting coming out of the finish of task 6. And you can see it going into the start of task 7, order dress. And if I pull the divider over here, you'll be able to see the contents of this predecessors column. And for task 7, it now has a predecessor of task 6. Now let's look at the durations of these tasks. Let's go back to select wedding dress. This is obviously very difficult to be absolute about, but let's suppose that the bride has decided that in order to select a wedding dress, it's really quite a long and complex process, she's probably going to need a couple of months. So let's say that in terms of working days, weekday working days, I appreciate that somebody wouldn't be planning a wedding purely on the basis of weekday working, but let's work on that basis for the moment. Let's call it 8 weeks. Let's call it 40 days. So if I click in the select wedding dress task, go to the duration, I'm going to delete what's there already and replace it with 40 days. That's fine, but in terms of ordering the dress, that's a very quick task. That's going to be a matter of perhaps going into a store and filling in a form, committing to spending a certain amount of money, probably paying a deposit on the dress. We'll talk about things like costs later on. And we're really going to say that that order is going to be placed in a day. So let's change one day estimated to one day without estimated. We can either just delete the question mark, or as you saw earlier on, we can go into the task information dialog and uncheck the estimated checkbox. Now once the dress has been ordered, the measurements and fittings can start. There'll be a sequence of these until the dress is finalized. And once again, let's assume that it's going to take a total period of 40 days for that to all happen. So we can select task 7 and we can select task 8. We could create a dependency in exactly the way that we did before. If I right click on the selection, if you look in the mini toolbar, there's a link button there, so I can do the link that way. And I can do the link before I establish the second duration. So let me double click on task 8, change its duration to not estimated and 40 days. There we are. And at the end of task 8, we should have a wedding dress. that fits. Now let's move on to task 9, select and order bridesmaid dresses. Now this is not a task which is completely independent of the wedding dress, because as I understand it, in general the wedding dress would be selected first, with a thought to what the bridesmaid dresses will be like, but you certainly wouldn't start selecting the bridesmaid dresses until you were certain about the wedding dress. So let's in this case say that the dependency is that we'll select the wedding dress before we select and order the bridesmaid dresses. Now in reality, not only would select and order bridesmaid dresses itself be broken down into subtasks, but even some of those subtasks would probably be broken down further. So for instance, measurements and fittings would probably be broken down into two or three subtasks. But let's stick with the level of detail that we've got. Let's establish that link and change the duration of the select and order bridesmaid dresses from an estimated 1 day to a total of 60 days. And as you can see, our schedule now takes us towards the end of April 2016. You can also see there that that one task, select wedding dress, has now a number of tasks dependent on it. And of course, any task can not only have several tasks depending on it, but it can depend on several tasks as well. Now let's start to look at these dependencies in a little bit more detail. There is a dependency from task 6 to task 9. We just set that up. If I hover over the arrow that represents that dependency, there is a screen tip that comes up that gives me a summary of the dependency. It's an FS, a finish to start dependency. That means that the first task in the dependency, that is select wedding dress, must finish before select and order bridesmaid dresses can start. And in fact, if I double click on that line, I get a task dependency dialog where I could, if I wanted to, change that dependency. So it says from select wedding dress to select and order bridesmaid dresses, there is a finish to start dependency with a lag of 0 days. Now, if I had decided in this particular case that after the wedding dress was selected and at the point that we were going to order it, we could certainly start looking at selecting and ordering bridesmaid dresses, but we needed to leave a gap of, say, 5 days for some reason, that would represent a lag of 5 days. And if I then click on that as my dependency, what you'll see is a 5-day gap. Effectively, we finish select wedding dress, then there's a 5-day gap, and then we select and order bridesmaid dresses. So that's a lag, and I could also have said, let's have a lag of minus 5 days. Now what that is, a negative lag, we often refer to as a lead. We still have a finish to start relationship, but what the relationship now says is that the second task can start 5 days before the first task finishes. So we can actually get started on selecting and ordering the bridesmaid dresses 5 days before we finish selecting the wedding dress. Now I'm going to restore that to being a lag of 0 days in a moment, but first of all I'd like you to look at the predecessors column. If you look at task 7, order dress, its predecessor was 6. Look at task 8, its predecessor was 7. Where all you see in the predecessor column is a number, that indicates a default finish to start relationship with zero lag. If there's more complexity to the dependency, then you'll see something such as you can see for task 9. The dependency is on task 6, so it begins with a 6. The FS basically says this is a finish to start dependency, which is the default. But the reason it says that is because it then says minus 5 days. So that code tells you that task 9 has a finish to start relationship with task 6, which means that 6 must finish before 9 starts, but there is a 5-day lead, so in effect task 9 can start 5 days before task 6 finishes. And whenever there is anything other than a standard default finish to start relationship, so if it's any other type of relationship, or if there is lag or lead, you'll see that coded in the predecessors column. So let me once again open up that dialog and change that back to being a zero lag. And just before I change this back the way it was, let's look at those other types of dependency. There are 4 types in total. There's finish to start, the default. There is start to start, which means that the second task can start when the first one does. Of course, you can apply lag or lead to any of these. Finish to finish, which means that the second task can only finish when the first task finishes. And there is a start to finish, which means that the second task can't finish until the first task starts. Now, by far the most common dependency is the finish to start, but you are very likely to come across the others. And in the next section or two, I'm going to show you one or two examples of these other types of dependency. The next task that I want to look at is the task of making the guest list. Now, making the guest list can be quite a long and controversial subject. I'm going to assume for the moment that it's going to take maybe 3 to 4 weeks to try to make sure that everybody that should be invited is invited. So let's change that 8 days to 15. But let's also say that once we've got some guests on the guest list who are definitely going to be invited, we might start sending out the invitations pretty much straight away. So sending out the invitations would be a task that would pretty much run throughout the period of making the guest list. We may even wait and see what responses we get to some of the invitations until we decide to, if you like, close the guest list. So let's extend send out invitation to be, say, a 20-day task. And let's say that it's going to start 5 days after making the guest list starts. So once we've been working on the guest list for a week, we're going to start sending out the first batch of invitations and see what sort of responses we get. So we'll link those two, and then what we're going to do is change that dependency from finish to start to start, and put in a 5-day lag start to start. We need to allow time for people to respond to invitations. As usual, quite a controversial subject, how long you would give people to respond to an invitation. But probably a figure of something like 2 or 3 weeks. So you're going to start sending out invitations on a particular date, and then over a period of time you'll send out some more, and you'll start to get replies back. But in reality, you can't really finalise the guest list until you've received all of the responses to the invitations. So what I'm going to do is to create a link between send out invitations and finalise guest list that works on the principle that you need to allow, say, 3 weeks from the end of sending out the invitations before you can actually finalize the guest list. So I'm going to create a link between those two, and I'm going to put a lag of 15 days in, and then instead of saying that it's a finish to start link, I'm going to say it's a finish to finish link, and I'm going to say that finalize guest list is just, say, a 5-day task. And what you can see there is a situation where at some point before our deadline we're going to start to finalize the guest list, but we're not actually going to be able to finish it until 15 days after we've sent out the last invitation. Now, of course, the way that I've done that was partly just to demonstrate these types of dependency. But you'll see from that also that when you're setting up dependencies, there are often a number of options to consider. And coming up with the right sort of dependency can sometimes involve quite a bit of thought and discussion. So we've put in quite a bit more detail into our plan now for the wedding. In the next section, we're going to look at constraints and deadlines, and we're also going to do a little bit more work on dependencies as well. So please join me for that.
Hi, I'm Molly. Thanks for watching. Get your project on time and under budget by watching our complete training courses for Microsoft Project 2016. Click the Learn More button on the right, and I'll see you next week with additional videos.